Yeah. Think some people still looking? You find it, we ask that you stand with us and we read a few verses of Mark 16. Amen.
Amen.
And it read, now when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, bought spice that they might come and anoint him. Very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen. And they said amongst themselves, who will roll away the stone from the door of the tomb for us? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away, for it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in a long white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him, as he said to you. So they went out quickly and fled from the tomb, for they trembled and was amazed, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. Yes, amen. May the Lord add a blessing.
Amen.
To the word.
Amen.
Who rolled the stone away?
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says that the women had waited until the Sabbath was passed. Amen. To finish embalming the body of Jesus. Amen. They went to Joseph's tomb where they had buried Jesus. And verse 2 in this text said, very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen. They had been waiting from the time they took Jesus down from the cross to finish embalming his body. Amen. Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, these women have proven themselves to be the most devoted followers of Jesus. Amen. They had proven themselves from the beginning, amen, as they followed Jesus through his ministry. They was there. Amen. Amen. That's something to say about these ladies. They were at the crucifixion. Amen. Of Jesus. Amen. They was there at the cross. Man, they was there when all his disciples had scattered. Huh? They had scattered for fear of their own lives. Man, because they believed that in their mind that they would lose their lives. Amen. If they were associated, a fire associated with Jesus. But if you've been with Jesus, amen, anytime, amen, people gonna find you out. Huh?
Yeah.
If you've been with Jesus, people gonna know that you've been with Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen. Because you're gonna act like Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen. You gonna look like Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen. Disciples had scattered. The only disciple that was there at the foot of the cross was John. Amen. And y'all remember John? He was the only one. All the other disciples had ran for their dear lives.
My Lord.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. But John was there. Can remember Jesus looked down at John and said, John, behold your mother. Amen. He said, Mother, behold your son. Amen. Amen. And they came, these women came to the tomb. As they came to the tomb, they were reasoning with themselves. Uh-huh. Amen. They were reasoning with themselves. Who will roll the stone away?
My Lord.
I don't know what was in their mind. Huh? I don't know how they was going to get this done. But they were determined to get it done.
Amen.
Amen. The Roman soldiers was there. And they had a seal, amen, on the stone.
Amen.
Amen. And nobody could break this seal. Amen. If they broke the seal, amen, they would lose their lives.
Amen.
So I don't know what the women were thinking when they said, amen, we're going to go there and finish embalming Jesus' body. But I do know that they were determined to do something.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. They were determined to do something. They were going to just sit there, amen, or hide in the upper room. They were going out there and they were willing to do something.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Even though I don't see how they were going to get in the tomb.
Amen.
Amen. And ask them. And as they went, they said, who's going to roll away the stone?
My Lord.
Amen. They had come to apply spices to a corpse.
Yes.
God, they went, amen. They was coming to put spices on a dead body.
Yeah.
But that was in their mind.
Yeah.
Amen. Because of the odor.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Of the body. Amen. They wanted to make sure he had the right amount of spices.
Yeah. My Lord.
Amen. On his body.
Thank you, Lord.
They had come expecting to see a dead body.
Jesus.
They said, who will roll away the stone from the door for us? It meant that the women did not expect to find an empty tomb.
Mm-hmm.
They were looking for a body. When they got to the tomb, the stone was already rolled away.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. If you look at Luke 24 and hear his account of this, and we see that Luke 24, amen, and 3 says, then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It goes on to say, and it happened as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them in shining garment. Then as they was afraid and bowed their face to the earth, they said to themselves, why do you seek the living among the dead?
My Lord.
He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered to the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again.
Yeah.
And then I like the next verse 8 said, and they remembered his word.
Yeah.
Amen. We're talking about the women now.
Yeah.
Amen. And then they returned from the tomb and told all these things to the 11 and to the rest of them. But then verse 11, and their words seemed to them like idle tales.
My Lord.
And they did not believe.
My Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many of us would have believed?
Yeah.
Amen. That a body was up, resurrected from the grave. Amen. These disciples who had been with Jesus, they heard Jesus speak over and over again that he was going to be crucified, but the third day he would rise. For some reason, it went in one way and just kept on going out. Amen. They didn't retain it in their mind for some kind of reason. Amen. And when the women ran to tell them that he was alive, amen, it seemed like idle tales, like they was lying, amen. But Peter and John, the Bible say, ran to the tomb. When they looked in, the body was gone. The clothes that was on his body was laying by themselves. John 20:7 said, and the handkerchief that had been around, wrapped around his head, was not lined with the linen cloth, but folded together in a place by itself.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. Do you believe if they stole the body, they would have took everything?
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Right now.
Who gonna take time and fold, hallelujah, the clothes or the wrap around his head and set it there neatly folded? Amen. His body was gone.
Yeah.
And the tomb was wide open.
Yeah.
Who rolled the stone away?
Yeah.
Amen. Who rolled the stone away? Matthew 28:2 tells us that it was an angel.
Yeah.
Amen. Who rolled the stone away?
Uh-huh.
Not to let Jesus out, but to let them see in.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? Jesus in his resurrected body could pass through material barriers. Can I get a witness? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It would roll away so you can see that he was gone. Amen. John 20:19 says, the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the door was shut, where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus stepped in the midst and stood in the middle of them and said, peace be with you. Amen. He didn't open the door. He didn't knock on the door. Amen. He just walked, appeared inside where they was hiding for fear of the Jews. Amen. So, hallelujah. Material barriers couldn't hold him down.
Yeah.
Amen. The stone was rolled away.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Not to let him out, but to let us know that he was risen.
Yeah.
Just as he said.
Yeah.
The stone was sealed with the Roman seal.
Yeah.
No one was allowed to break the seal.
Yeah.
But God sent an angel
and
rolled the stone away. And the guards who was guarding the tomb trembled for fear of the angels and became as dead men. Matthew 28:4. But the angel said to the women, do not be afraid, for I know that you see Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and to meet him in Galilee. There you will see him. Amen. If you go to Mark, Matthew 28 with me. Matthew 28. Amen. I'm going to look at verse 8. And it says, so they went out quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to bring him, his disciples, the word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, rejoice.
Yes.
So they came and held him by his feet and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. Amen. 1 hour earlier, the women were going to embalm the body of Jesus. But they thought he was dead. Being obedient to the angels to go and tell his disciples to meet him in Galilee. And they was obedient. Jesus met them on the way and said, rejoice. Rejoice. And they held him by the feet and they worshiped him. Amen. He was dead, but now he is alive. Can I get a witness? The message from Jesus and through the angels were to be delivered by the women to his disciples. It was an invitation to meet Jesus in Galilee. The disciples had completely failed Jesus. Amen. And Jesus told them that they was. In Matthew 26, he told them that they're going to smite the shepherd. Hallelujah. And the sheep was going to scatter. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They had completely failed Jesus. Amen. When they ran. They ran for their own life. Jesus was on his own. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But Peter, amen, when God said, go and tell Peter too. Amen. Because they didn't know where Peter was at. Peter had denied my Savior three times. Amen. Now Peter was feeling kind of bad. Amen. So Jesus told them, when you tell the disciple, tell Peter too. Amen. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness? Amen. This was grace. Amen. It was grace and mercy. God extended his grace. Can I get a witness? Amen. God extended his love. Amen. Because they had ran and failed God. Amen. But God know us before we know ourselves. Amen. And he knows when we mess up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he knows how to forgive. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. That's why he was on the cross. Amen. He died for every one of our sins. Amen. Romans 8 said God demonstrated his love toward us. Amen. And then that while we were yet sinners, amen, he still died for us. Amen. And I thank God for dying for me. Amen. His grace and mercy. Amen. It's so great. Amen. It's so good. Amen. It's so loving. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, go tell my disciples. Amen. Even though they was hiding behind closed doors. Amen. To meet me in Galilee. Amen. I tell you, Christ died for us. But he got up. Can I get a witness? In Galilee, Jesus continued to teach them the word of God. Can I get a witness? Amen. In Galilee, he continued teaching them the word of God. Amen. He was there for 40 days. The Bible say, hallelujah, over 500 disciples. Amen. Was there. Hallelujah, in Galilee, before God descended up in the cloud. Can I get a witness? Amen. He said, you are my disciple. Go into all the world and teach the word. Can I get a witness? And God is saying the same thing to each and every one of us that are in the building today. Amen. Don't settle the word. Amen. Now, hallelujah. Get up off the word. Amen. Get up on your feet. Amen. As he told the disciples. Amen. I want you to preach the word in Jerusalem. Amen. And I want you to preach the word in Judea. Amen. And I want you to preach the word in Samaria. Amen. And I don't want you to stop there. I want you to go Amen. He lives within me. Amen. And I'm so thankful. Amen. That he lives. Amen. You thank God today for the message. Amen. Do you receive the message today? Amen. He lives.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you.
Who will roll a stone away?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The
thank
angels.
Lord.
Roll the stone away.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Jesus. Amen. Not to let him out.
Yeah.
Amen. He was already gone.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.
He is Lord.
Hallelujah,
he is Lord.
He is Lord.
He has
risen from the dead. He is Lord.
Oh, oh, oh. Those in the church are open. We'll ask one this morning. Oh, yeah.